Hey, good morning. It's Lynda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado, and you can find this video and other content eventually at lyndacromar.com. That's my blog, and that's also where I share lots of good ideas on how to make money online. Anyway, today we're going to talk about, and you're probably not going to like this one, but it's really the truth, and I've found myself doing it too, so I'm not completely innocent, and that is why we truly make our excuses. I did it for a long time. I kind of sloughed off, didn't really give my full attention to what I needed to do, and played a lot of the time through most of my morning, and then hurried to do all of my work. And sometimes I didn't get it done. So I would make an excuse. And that is the true reason why we make excuses. It's because we probably put something else in front of what needs to happen, whatever it is. Now, it can be something that someone else brings to fore, but it can also be things we do ourselves. Because the more we get in a habit to do that, the more we make excuses. What's a better way? Have a plan and execute it immediately every single day. Having a good, solid, successful routine in the morning is one of the biggest success attributes that I am working to perfect, and I believe that is what you will find most successful people do. They don't spend their morning just frittering it away. They spend that morning doing the most productive things they possibly can to build their business and to build a successful personal life as well. It all depends on what your goals are, of course. But if you want success, you have to stop making excuses. And what's a better way? Make a plan and execute it immediately. And what would that plan have to do? What kind of things would be important to have in that plan? Well, for me, and this is just my own, very first thing I do in the morning is I get up and I work on a few things that are I can do behind the scenes that do not have anything to do with the timing of when I do it. For instance, I get the blog out of the way early. I send my email. Well, I actually schedule it because I want it to go out in the evening, but I schedule it first thing in the morning. So if later in the day, because I have a husband I care for that is actually has Alzheimer's, I might have to drop everything and go take care of his needs. Right now, he's still asleep. So if I get everything done early in the morning, and sometimes I start as early as 4:30 or 5. Now, maybe that's earlier than you want to start. But I've found that if I can get up a few hours before he's even moving, I can get a lot done. And then I can feel good about my day, even if I don't get anything else done the rest of the day. And guess what? I'm not making an excuse, and therefore I'm not belittling my self-esteem. Because that's what you're really doing when you're making excuses. It's not for the other guy, it's for you. It's your reason why you didn't get something done, and you want to make it sound as convincing as possible, but in the end, it's really a lie. I didn't get it done because I didn't plan accordingly to get it done. That's the real truth. And that's what I have to start saying to myself. So rather than having to say that, I have planned my routine. So what else do I put in my early routine? Well, exercise is something I'm not fond of doing. So I get it done in a hurry, quick and early in the morning. You know what it has done for me, though, now that it's a habit instead of something I have to force myself to do? I have more energy, natural energy, not something I had to get from coffee or some other kind of stimulant. And that makes me feel good, too. Another thing I do is I make the breakfast. Now, Kay and I, we believe in eggs and bacon. Now, that's not necessarily the best breakfast for everybody, but it is for me. I get some protein. I get some natural fat right away, which are all things that help with energy. cereal is not necessarily the best kind of thing to eat the first thing in the morning because it's full of carbohydrates, and those are things that will add to your fat but not necessarily add to your energy. You want to do the things that are going to help with the energy first thing in the morning because you want to have a clear mind and lots of energy. So I get my breakfast done. I eat. I make sure I have some orange juice, some good vitamin C. I like to get the concentrated and make it up myself, and that way I can be in control of how much is available at any one time. Once I've got all that done, I get some more marketing done, and I'm almost done by the end of about 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning. Now, that sounds kind of interesting, doesn't it? My day is actually done after I've done this video, and I don't have to do anything else, but the rest of it is gravy. Now, I'm going to probably spend some time talking to people. That's my last piece, and I'm going to do that during the day, all through the day. But one of the things that makes this cool is that I don't have to be in a hurry to do it because I've done all the other things that could be done a little earlier than the normal working hours that some people have. And I find this really quite pleasing to me now that I have a routine that feels good. And then I don't have to make an excuse. Now, you have to plan your day according to your own family rhythm, whatever that is. Your rhythm might be totally different. Early morning might be the most worst time for you to do what you have to do because you have family that has to get up, kids that have to get ready for school. I don't know if they're going back to an actual school, or you may have to do the homeschooling and that kind of stuff, and you can't put that off. Those things are important. So you have to plan around those things and make a decision. Where am I going to fit it in? Because if you make it last, building your business, if you make it last instead of first, sometimes it'll drop off the list and won't get done at all. And that's what I've found happened to me in the past. And maybe it's happening to you now. You know, we're living in a different time now since this COVID came into our lives, and we may never go back to a different routine similar to the past. We have to adjust and change as things change around us. So making excuses is not the plan. Adjusting and building a good, positive routine is. And that's what I have to share with you today. And like I said, if you want to learn more about how to build a business online, check me out at lyndacromar.com. And I will talk to you again probably tomorrow. Bye for now.